extrinsic daily quality control. Begin by entering QA calibration menu from the main screen of the Jetstream acquisition program. Typing in the name of the study, capitals double X space QC space daily space EXD for extrinsic. ID for the study, enter the date and your initials. If you have used this ID already, add a letter following your initials. Initiate the extrinsic flood QA program protocol. Update the correct collimator ID. Ensure that the acquisition is set for 18 million counts. Select the appropriate isotope. Select cobalt 57 if you are using a sealed cobalt sheet source. Select technetium if you are using a technetium filled phantom sheet source. Next, initiate extrinsic both pre-programmed motion. This pre-programmed motion can be initiated either with the imaging bed latched in its operational position or unlatched and swung aside. Observe that the system has completed the pre-programmed motion. Utilize the mobile shield by placing it near the detectors. It is appropriate for the extrinsic test since the scatter will not affect the flood acquisition. Obtain the extrinsic planar sheet source. Here we are using the sealed cobalt 57 sheet source. This one can be placed directly onto the detector head. Ensure not to run the corners of the source into the detector. Place it flat onto the detector face. If using a fillable phantom sheet source, we would have to place blue pads first onto the detector head before placing the sheet source on top. Move the detector head slowly together. The sheet source may have to be placed on spacers equidistant to the two detectors in case the activity and the count rate are too high when the source is placed directly next to the detectors. From the main protocol page, enter the peaking feature, choose both detectors, confirm the position of the peak, numerical value, and visually confirm the position of the imaging window over the peak for each detector. Accept the peak if appropriate. Proceed into the P-scope and preparation of the acquisition. Confirm that the count rates are within acceptable limits and start the acquisition. Note the progress slider and confirm that the acquisition is in progress. After the flat acquisition is complete, carefully move the detector heads apart. Retrieve the shield for the source. Lift it gently off of the detector head, ensuring that you are not scratching the touchpad collimator surface. Now we are ready to prepare for the daily workflow by initiating patient loading pre-programmed motion. Ensure that the motion is complete. At the EBW processing station, select your flood study. Ensure that both detector images are under the study. Analysis for the extrinsic flood is done similarly to the intrinsic flood. From the analysis menu, initiate the QC Tools application. Select Detector 1 image. And begin the qualitative analysis by right-clicking and selecting Gray Level. Scroll to remove overall intensity and background intensity. Identify areas of lower and higher counts. return intensity to normal and observe if the higher and lower count areas are blending back into the image. Confirm that the area of the analysis for uniformity is correct. Press OK. Obtain the quantitative uniformity analysis for a useful field of view. And central field of view. We see that the software identified areas of higher and lower counts within the field of view. Note the integral and differential values. Repeat analysis for detector 2 image. Confirm that the analysis area is correct for detector 2. Press OK to perform the quantitative analysis for detector 2. Compare the values obtained to detector 1 values and to the official acceptance limits for uniformity. Log the extrinsic uniformity values under appropriate date, confirming that they are within the extrinsic limits. And sign off to complete your record.